Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. Boreaspis was an osteostracan Agnathan vertebrate that lived in the Devonian period. At least 14 distinct species of Boreaspis are known from early Devonian sandstones in Spitsbergen. Nonetheless, some of these likely did not belong to the genus. For instance, the species Boreaspis robusta and Boreaspis costata have been reassigned to Spatulaspis and Boreaspis circinus, Boreaspis curtirostris, and Boreaspis gracilis now belong to Dicranaspis. They differ in the length of their bony spine that grew out from the cheek area on either side and in the width of their triangular-shaped head shield. The snout was elongated in all species into a blade-like rostrum. Their head shields were quite small at 0.79 inches or 2 centimeters long. It also had two pointed extensions that protruded from the base to the sides, increasing hydrodynamic efficiency. Beside its hydrodynamic function, the rostrum was possibly used to probe on the muddy lagoon floor for prey. Boreaspis means Boreas shield. It was named by Stencio in 1927. It belongs to the kingdom Animalia, the phylum Chordata, the class Osteostraci, the order Banibiaspidida, family Boreaspididae, and genus Boreaspis. Species include the type, which is Boreaspis rostrata, and other species like Boreaspis batoides, Macrorhynchus, Intermedia, Ceratops, Puella, Spinacornis, and Triangularis. I probably mispronounced quite a few of those names, but it may have been a detritivore. It was 5 inches or 13 centimeters long. It has been found in Spitsbergen, Svalbard, northern Norway, Europe. And it lived during the Pragian, the Emsian of the early Devonian, roughly 410 to 393 million years ago. And fossil representation includes numerous individuals. Thank you for watching. I'm slowly creating more videos on unknown and obscure species because I plan to make a collection of most of the key species in Earth's evolutionary history. We could even create 3D models and literally go back in time in a virtual reality experience. These videos serve as the guides to learning more about the prehistoric creatures, bizarre and weird, that lived eons ago. I'm very excited to make this idea a reality. As always, this is Enchiridion. See you next time.